Yo, what up, guys? Welcome back to Patched.
Welcome back. Yes. Today we got a highly requested one. We got the Razer Huntsman Elite keyboard. So they got their little laser opto mechanical key switches on there. Mm. So, I mean, how'd that turn out?
We'll see about that. If you guys want to get it, we'll leave a link in the description box. This goes, well, I mean, when it came out, it went for $200 freaking.
Yeah.
It's on sale at like places at like Best Buy and Amazon online for like $160.
Yeah.
So I guess it's, you know, it's still a little cheaper, but it's still expensive, you know?
Yeah.
So yeah, we've been playing with it, and let's get it started off with the bottom. So as far as the bottom goes, we have just plastic, you know, just regular plastic. And then we have very, very large feet. So we got three large feet on the bottom and three large feet on top. And we have adjustable feet. When we have two angles for the adjustable feet here. So, you know, obviously if you want it a little bit higher.
Yeah, exactly.
I always love that. You can set it to whatever angle you would like. So that's nice and premium. And as far as the thickness of the actual keyboard goes, it's very thick. It's pretty damn thick.
It's thick, but it also doesn't have those like those the sides that like come up because they've got that little volume rocker there.
No, that's true.
But the cable for this is braided. They've got two USBs, even though there's no USB pass through on this guy, which is kind of strange.
It's weird.
Also, another technical detail to note: there's only 10 key rollover instead of N key rollover, which means you can only press 10 keys at a time and have them register instead of, you know, unlimited. Not that that matters. I feel like after 10 keys, like, is there anything that actually requires you to press that many keys at a time?
As well as the wire not being able to, you know, detach, and it's actually connected to the keyboard. So that kind of sucks if you want to have your own, I guess, custom wire or something like that. And also, it comes with a hand rest, you know, a wrist rest, and it feels pretty nice. The leather's soft. I'm not sure, is this real leather? I mean, it feels pretty nice.
I'm pretty sure it is.
Yeah.
I don't know, I usually don't like wrist rests, like every now and then I find one that I like. This one is really nice.
Yes.
It's actually, I appreciate that. And RGB.
Yes.
Yeah, lights up.
Yeah, it has a nice cushion though, it's very comfortable. And yeah, I don't like wrist rests either, but you know, this feels actually pretty damn nice. So you can see the gold contacts, you know, which powers the actual wrist rest for the RGB. And then it's actually magnetic, so that's pretty nice and convenient. You just snap that on, it's ready to go. As far as the actual material goes, it's made of anodized aluminum, which feels nice. It's actually very cold to the touch right now. So Razer's using their proprietary key switches. And we got the purple kind. There's also a red kind, which is linear. The purple is tactile. As you guys can see, it reminds you of just a regular box switch, but with a lot of other stuff added to it. You guys can see the stabilizers, you know, the metal kind of wire looking thing. Does it actually work, you know? So as far as the stabilizers go, I mean, it feels a little bit stable.
There's less wobble than other keyboards.
Just a tiny bit less.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, it's not super noticeable, but you know, I can feel it just a little bit, like when I have another keyboard just to like, you know, test the difference, then I can tell the difference, but it's not like huge, like very, very noticeable. There's still a little bit of key wobble.
But I mean, the important part is when you press down each key, you get a nice even press, which is what they're really going for there.
But I mean,
That's any key.
Yeah, I mean, that's like any key, you know, that like, most keys do that, right? So, I mean, is it like necessary to add all of these like metal wires to all the keycaps? I don't really know, you know? But as far as the actual switch goes, it feels pretty nice though. It's super loud though.
Yeah. So, I mean, it's 45 grams of actuation for the purple, 40 grams for the red switches. But these feel super light on the purples. And the actuation distance on the reds, I believe, is 1 millimeter, and then 1.5 millimeters on the purple.
Oh my god, that's really short.
But being that the reds are lighter, and the actuation distance is shorter, I'd be worried about accidental key presses on those.
Exactly, and you can't adjust it. And of course, like Lucas said, they have their laser switches.
It's opto-mechanical. So it basically, there's a little laser in there. When you press it down, it blocks the laser, and that's how it instantly sort of inputs into the system. Like, hey, they press down the key. And when you let go, so they say it actuates and resets at the exact same time. So, I mean, that's cool.
That is cool, but you can't adjust the actual distance, which really sucks, you know?
But it's interesting. It's an interesting concept, and I like the fact that we're trying to make things faster, but I don't really notice it at all when I was playing. Like, it's not, like, it doesn't feel any faster than your average keyboard. Although I know it is, it doesn't feel faster.
Yeah.
I don't know.
All right, and as far as the actual keycaps go, I mean, they don't feel very nice to me, especially for a $200 keyboard. It feels a little slippery, and there's a nice little shine to it, and you can, and like, if your hands are oily and sweaty, you can definitely see the residue that's left from your fingertips onto the keycaps.
Yeah, and we cannot find for the life of us what these are made of, but we can only assume ABS just based off of sort of what's going on with it as far as like the fingerprint grease, and it's a little slipperier.
Mm-hmm. And also there is a nice little curved shape like we see in most keyboards.
Concave.
Yeah, concave shape for your fingers.
But what I do like is the font on there. Mm-hmm. Super sick, it's thin. I mean, it's pretty much the same font that Razer always uses. And the shine through is fantastic on these. It's phenomenal. As well as the RGB, you get very, very accurate coloring on the RGB, which, I mean, it's a small thing, but I like it. You know?
I personally don't care, but, you know, that's cool.
If you pay $200 for a keyboard and you don't get a good RGB, I'd be pissed off. I'll put it that way.
Okay. As well as, you know, you have some media key controls here, and it seems like they're made of metal or aluminum, but, I mean, The click is nice, but the actuation distance is so
it's weird.
Literally like you just there's no distance. It just clicks. You know,
it's kind of awkward for the media keys.
Yeah.
But I do like the roller. The
roller's nice.
Really cool.
Yeah,
that's a lot of steps on it too.
Exactly, very tactile steps. You know,
this guy's also rated for 100 million keystrokes, which is crazy. That's like double what we usually see on keyboards.
Yeah,
I don't think I've ever gotten to like, I don't know, more than 10 million on a single keyboard.
Yeah.
But, I mean, hey, you can do it.
You can do it. It'll take some years. And
run
it
up.
You have to use this for a lot of years, but you can do it, you know?
The one thing that really bugs me is the like, mechanical, like, pinging. It's like a little, every time you, like, lift up a key or press certain ones down, you get this, like, pinging sound, and it's really bothersome. Obviously, when you're gaming, you'll have a headset on, and you won't really notice it, but it's I don't know. It's
super loud.
The keys are very loud.
Yeah.
Very, very loud. And there's no real way around that. The linear one's not much better.
You guys want to hear it? You know what I'm saying? So, and I mean, it feels nice. The tactile switches do feel nice, but it's just super loud. I don't like it. On my N2 Pro, you know, the brown switches that I have, it's not nearly as loud as this. But anyway, that's just a little thing. As well as like $200 being super expensive. I mean, is it worth it? I don't know, to be honest, I don't think it's worth the $200 because, I mean, I would never spend $200. I mean, I did, but that's for reviewing, you know what I'm saying? But I personally, I wouldn't spend $200 on a keyboard like this. I mean, I think they could have done a little bit better on the actual keycaps.
Yeah.
And maybe thin it out a little bit, you know? I mean, usually I don't really care about how thick the keyboard is, but this one's like pretty dang thick, you know?
I'd like to see companies trying some new things. I mean, like these big companies like Logitech and Razer, I mean, they're not really doing the 65% of the 60% keyboards, which everyone is sort of craving these days. So I'd like to see sort of a version of this without, you know, maybe even a 10 keyless, you know? Just something that's not such a fat keyboard to be on my desk, you know?
Yeah.
Keep in mind, I mean, the Tournament Edition, you can get 10 keyless, but the Huntsman Elite, at the time of making this video, there is no way to get anything but the full size.
Yeah.
I mean, as far as the software goes for this guy, you're still using Razer Synapse, which is, everyone's got their opinions about it. I'll let you guys go off in the comments about it. I mean, it's okay.
Much improved from before, though.
It is improved from before.
Yeah.
Still not exactly a fan of it myself. Mm-hmm. But that's, I mean, my minor detail. You don't really have to have the Razer Synapse, but I mean, if you want to adjust the RGB or macros, anything like that, you'd have to have their software. As far as the pricing goes, $200, yeah, I don't think I would pay $200 for this. You can find it on sale for $160, but even still, I think I'd pay like $120 max.
Yeah.
For something like this.
Yeah.
It's cool. I like the technology. I think technology is really improving, and I think that's fantastic. But the price point's very steep for this guy.
Mm-hmm.
I understand the cost of development for something like this is also a lot of money. So, I mean, it's justifiable right now, but I'd love to see this stuff come to a more sort of, I don't know, consumer level pricing, or a more reasonable pricing, competitive, I suppose, is the word I was looking for there.
So yeah, that's our review of the Razer Huntsman Elite. If you guys want to get it, we'll leave links below. Thank you guys for watching, and we'll see you guys next one.
See you in the next one.